I would like to remake the video for the domain of the function x to the x power because I'm not satisfied with the answer I gave you guys in the previous video, and I believe that I did make some mistakes too. So hopefully this one is going to be better, and I want to thank everybody who gave me the inputs in the previous video. And I also try to make this video short. Here we go. First, the x to the x power. One thing that I want to mention, f of 0, we get 0 to the 0, and this thing is perhaps the worst thing ever because it has no agreement. In my opinion, this is worse than no real value. Because people tell you, hey, this is equal to 1. But some other people tell you 0 to 0 is undefined. For example, Google calculator says 0 to 0 is equal to 1. But Wolfram Alpha says 0 to 0 is undefined. As long as you don't say 0 to 0 is equal to 0, as long as you don't say 0 to 0 is equal to 17, then you can go ahead and debate is either 1 or undefined. Yes, no agreement. So in this video, I don't want x to be 0, right? Because it's annoying. Yeah, so let's get rid of that. Now, if you have seen this function in your Calc 1 class, most likely, you only saw it in the first quadrant when x is greater than 0. And then the function is also greater than 0. Why? I'll tell you. This right here is because for the function to be continuous. So for continuity purpose. If you graph this real quick, okay, 0 to 0 doesn't work, yeah, no agreement. But if you take the limit as x approaching 0 from the right-hand side, the limit for that is equal to 1. That everybody can agree. So this right here is 1, and I'll just put open circle because I said x is not equal to 0. And the interesting part about this function is that it actually goes down a little bit first and then come back up. Yeah? And then when x is equal to 1, you have 1 to the 1, so it's just 1. This minimum actually happens at 1 over e, which is a very interesting number. I do have a video on graphing this, so if you want to check that out, link will be in the description for you. But besides that, why don't we take a look at the negative numbers? Because remember, for the domain, the definition is that it's the set of all possible inputs. And since I'm using x for the input here, I will just write down all possible x values. Can we have negative numbers? Yes. For example, if I put negative 1 into x, this right here is just equal to negative 1 raised to the negative 1 power. This negative power tells you to bring this down to the bottom and then raise to the positive first power. And if you work this out, this is totally legit. You end up with negative 1. And of course, right here, I should also have mentioned that we are trying to find the real domain. This is the real number, so we are good. But we have to be careful sometimes though. If we have f of negative 1/2, this right here will give us negative 1/2 raised to the negative 1/2 power, and that's 1 over this inside, and then raised to the positive 1/2. But the 1/2 power turns to be a square root. And a square root of a negative number, unfortunately, this right here is no longer real. Now you get the I on the bottom, but whatever you do, it's not a real number. So we have to be careful on the types of negative numbers that we can use. And as I said, we only saw x greater than 0 in a Calc 1 class for continuity purpose. Because when x is equal to negative 1, for example, you get negative 1, you have a point. The graphing softwares, they don't show you the point because it's just like a little dot, like little point, you cannot see that. And in fact, you cannot really graph the next point. Now, there's no such thing as the number right before negative 1 or after negative 1. Right. So let's see though, what are the things that we can use? I would just like to tell you, and then I want to thank the viewers who suggest me to write down the answer for this. Some negative numbers works, some don't. Well, if you have an even denominator on the bottom, it won't work because you end up with like an even root of a negative number. that's not going to be real. But if you have an odd denominator, it will work. For example, f of negative 1/3. This tells you we have 1 over negative 1 over 3 raised to the negative 1 over 3. And that's 1 over negative 1 over 3 raised to the positive 1 over 3. But this turns out to be a cube root. So 1 over cube root of a negative number. And this right here, it's actually a real number. Yeah. For example, just like a little note on the side, when we have a cube root of negative 1, this is equal to negative 1. So all we have to do is write this, x, as long as we have a negative rational numbers with odd denominator, it will work. So we can write it as m over odd number. I will write it as 2n. Don't use plus 1, use minus 1 is better. And then I want this to be negative, so I'll just put negative right in front. That's so much easier than the answer I gave you guys previously. Here though, we want n and m to be in positive integers. Why don't I write n? Because this is also no agreement. Like n, the natural numbers, do you include the 1? I mean, do you include the 0? Or do you not include the 0? Again, it has no agreement. Is 0 a natural number or not? So I don't like that. Let's just put m and n to be a positive integers. And notice that if n is equal to 1, 2 times 1 is 2, minus 1 is 1. So we get negative integers. In fact, any negative integers will work. So that's pretty much it. And an honorable mention is that when we have a negative irrational number raised to a negative irrational number, you are not going to get any real results. I will make another video. I will work out negative pi to a negative pi over there for you guys. For now, I just want to keep the video short and I just want to show you guys what will work. That is pretty much it. So I'm going to write down the domain for you guys now. Hopefully this time we get it right. We have the set of all x in the reals such that either x is greater than 0 or x is in the form of negative m over 2n minus 1, where m and n are in the positive integers. And because m is a positive integer, so we are not going to include 0 here, so don't worry. And that's it. Let me know what you guys think.